Our next one is cash book. Cash book is most important for final examination. Definitely you will get 110 mark problem in our exam. Then come to clarify, the cash book is classified into three types: three column cash book, single column cash book, and petty cash book. Petty cash book is not mandatory, but it will depends on student assumption. We have to identify transaction, then we have to prepare particular columns to individual transaction. That we will learn our next chapter. Particularly cash book is having a separate chapter, but in our structural book we are not class. Sorry. Satisfying this cash book transaction into our structural book transaction. Come to which type of transactions we have to enter into our cash book. Let us start from first transaction. Purchase goods from Srinu. So this transaction will be enter into credit side of cash book. Purchase goods for cash. Here cash word is there. Purchase. This is also a part of credit side transaction. Sold goods to Srinu. To Srinu, he is receiving. This is also part of other transaction. It will be converted into debit side of cash book. Sold goods for cash. It will be converted into credit side of, sorry, debit side of cash book. That we have to identify, but now I am not explaining clearly about the cash book. Definitely we are going to learn each and every single word of explanation in our next chapter, that is cash book. And come to know the next one, journal and proper. Journal proper. Again I am repeating, no need to pronounce journal proper, journal proper. Pronounce it as journal proper. Journal proper is classified into opening, adjustment. In this journal proper we have to enter opening entries, closing entries, adjustments we have to identify in our journal proper. This journal proper is 2 marks problem. Journal proper is relating to 2 marks problem. Yes, these are the 8 types of class subject books. Again I am repeating, first one purchase book. In purchase book we have to enter name of the credit based purchase transaction, no need to enter cash based purchase transactions. And next one sales book. In sales book also we have to enter sales transaction based on name. If the transaction including along with the sales, if the cash word is there, then we don't want to enter those transactions into our sales book. And come to purchase return book. Purchase return is nothing but if the goods are returned to, clearly we have to identify 2 words, then we have to enter the transaction into purchase return. And come to next one, sales returns book. Sales return is nothing but if the goods are returned from is there, or if the goods are returned by is there, those transactions we have to convert into sales return. According to bills payable is nothing but it is responsible to credit system, means how much amount we are paying, how much amount equivalent to product we are owing, those transactions we have to identify. And bills receivable is nothing but the payment is always usable to the organization or not. In this bills payable, sorry, in this bills receivable we have to identify debt system. And next one, cash book. Cash book is classified into, and it is also most important for 10 marks. First one is 3 column, single column, and next one petty cash book. Each and individual problem we are going to solve in our next chapter. And last one is journal proper. In our journal proper, we have to identify opening, closing, and adjustment entries into our journal proper. These all are the 8 types of subject books.